In this video, we're going to simplify numerical expressions containing rational exponents. So the definition of a raised to the 1 over n is let the nth root of a be a real number and n a positive integer greater than 1, then a to the 1 over n is equal to the nth root of a. So for number 1, it wants us to convert each expression to radical form and evaluate if possible. So we have 64 to the 1/2, and we can rewrite that as the square root of 64. And now the square root of 64 is equal to 8. In the second one, we have negative 64 to the 1/2. So we have the negative out in front of the radical and the square root of 64. And then when we evaluate that, it's equal to negative 8. And this last one, we have negative 64 in parentheses raised to the 1/2. And that means that the negative sign is inside the square root. So we have the square root of negative 64. And this is not real. So we can't evaluate the square root of negative 64. In B, we have 64 to the 1/3, and that is equal to the cube root of 64, which is equal to 4. And now we have negative 64 to the 1/3, so the negative is going on the outside of our cube root, so minus the cube root of 64, and the cube root of 64 is 4, and then we have the negative, so it's negative 4. And now we have negative 64 in parentheses all raised to the 1/3, so the negative is going to go inside of our radical this time. So we have the cube root of negative 64, and that is equal to negative 4. Now it says, let the nth root of a be a real number, and m and n be positive integers, where m and n share no common factors, and n is greater than 1. So, number 1, definition of a raised to the m divided by n. 1, a to the m divided by n is equal to a to the 1 over n, all raised to the m, which is also equal to the nth root of a all raised to the m. 2, a to the m divided by n is equal to a to the m all raised to the 1 over n, which is equal to the nth root of a to the m. Number 2, definition of a raised to the negative m divided by n. 1, a raised to the negative m divided by n is equal to 1 over a all raised to the m divided by n, which is equal to 1 over a raised to the m divided by n. Or 2, a divided by b all raised to the negative m divided by n is equal to b over a all raised to the m divided by n. So in 2, it wants us to evaluate 8 to the 2/3 by writing it as in parts 1 and 2 of definition and then simplifying. So for A, we're going to use part 1, and we're going to write 8 to the 2/3 as 8 to the 1/3 all squared, which is also equal to the cube root of 8 all squared, which is equal to 2 squared, the cube root of 8 is 2, and squared, which is equal to 4. And then for part 2, we're going to rewrite 8 to the 2/3 as 8 squared raised to the 1/3, and then we can write it as the cube root of 8 squared. And 8 squared is equal to 64, so then we have the cube root of 64, which is equal to 4. So you can see, regardless of which method we used, part 1 of definition 1 or part 2 of definition 1, we still get the same answer. In 3, it says, simplify 27 over 8 to the 2/3. And then it asks, would it be easier to use part 1 or part 2 of definition 1? And here it would be easier to use part 1 so that we don't have to square 27. So when we use part 1, we're going to have 27 over 8 to the 1/3, and then we're going to square it. The cube root of 27 is equal to 3. And the cube root of 8 is equal to 2, so we have 3/2 squared, and 3 squared is equal to 9, and 2 squared is equal to 4. So we have 27 over 8 to the 2/3 is equal to 9/4. In 4, it says, simplify each expression, begin by first applying definition 2. And definition 2 has us changing our negative exponent to a positive exponent. So in A, we have 64 to the negative 5/6. In order to make negative 5/6 positive, we're going to, instead of writing 64, we're going to write 1 over 64. So we can say that this is equal to 1 over 64 to the 5/6. And now, I'm going to take the 6th root of 1 over 64 first because it's easier. So I'm going to write this as the 6th root of 1 over 64 raised to the 5th power. And the 6th root of 1 over 64 is equal to 1/2. So we have 1/2 to the 5th power. And 1/2 to the 5th power is equal to 1 over 32. In B, we have 36 over 25 to the negative 1/2 power. And when we use definition 2, we're going to flip our fraction inside the parentheses. So we're going to have 25 over 36. And now, instead of being raised to the negative 1/2, it's going to be raised to the 1/2. And we can write 25 over 36 to the 1/2 as the square root of 25 over 36. The square root of 25 is equal to 5, and the square root of 36 is equal to 6. So 36 over 25 to the negative 1/2 power is equal to 5/6. And that's our video on simplifying numerical expressions containing rational exponents.